Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. We're going to do some more problems involving percent increase and percent decrease, where we're looking for what the percent increase or decrease is. And so here again is the definition. And remember, we're always going to write our answer in terms of percent. So we have to remember to write our answer as a percent by multiplying it by 100%. So here's our first example. The monthly tuition at a private school is $3,000 per month. The school is raising tuition to $3,510 per month. What percent increase is this? So we're looking for our percent. Okay, and remember what we need to know. How much did it go up or down? So our base, which goes in the denominator, right, the original amount, is what it was first. What was it first? It was this $3,000 per month. So we know it started at $3,000 per month, and that's the base or the original amount goes in the denominator. And then we want to know how much it went up. That goes in the numerator. How much did it go up? Well, it's now 3,510, so it went up by $510. So it went up by $510. So this is the percent written as a fraction, right? In other words, it's the answer written as a fraction. We want to write it as a percent, so let's multiply by 100% so that our answer will be in terms of percents. Let's see, I could divide top and bottom by 100 right off the bat, eliminating those two zeros and those two zeros. And in fact, I can also, right here, divide by 10, right? The 510 divided by 30, getting rid of those zeros. So I've got 51 over 3%. Now, by the way, if you did this in the calculator, you're going to get the same answer. I don't like to have to get out my calculator, but you could do 510 times 100, divide by 3,000, put it all on your calculator, and you're going to get 17%. So tuition went up by 17%. Here's the next problem. So why don't you put the video on pause and try this on your own first? Enrollment at a dance studio went down from 320 students to 256 students in the summer. What is the percent decrease? So the number of students decreased, right? So again, we're looking for our percent decrease. And our original amount is what always goes in the denominator. So that 320, that's how many students we had originally. So we have 320 in the denominator. And in the numerator, it's not how many students we now have, it's the decrease, right, in students. And how many students did it decrease by? We have to subtract. So let's see, this is how I do subtraction. Don't worry about it if you don't get it. So what is that? 64? There are 64 fewer students. Okay, so remember, it's how many students it went down by or up by if we were doing increase. And we've got to multiply by 100% because we want to write it as a percent. Okay, so let's see. I'm going to do this a little bit differently. Now, again, you could put this all in the calculator and get the answer. I like to use my mind. So I'm dividing top and bottom by 10. I'm going to do that to get rid of those zeros. Okay? And then instead of multiplying by 10 here, I'm going to just divide the 64 divided by 32. Hopefully you noticed that 64 is twice as big as 32. So when I cancel that, I'm going to actually get 2. So I end up with 2 times 10, 20%. Again, you will get the same answer, canceling it however way you want, and then multiplying by 100% or using a calculator or whatever. So, boy, that's a bad decrease for them during the summer. Went down 20%, 20% students. So they now still have, how many students do they still have? They still have 80% of their students. Hopefully that makes sense to you. If there are 20% less students, there are 80% that are still going to dance class in the summer. All right, here's our next problem. A store bought a necklace for $16 and sold it for $40. By the way, you might notice that's a big markup, but that's common with jewelry. What was their percent increase? So, in other words, the store has a percent increase, but that's not what they call it. They usually call it the markup rate. Markup rate talks about the percent increase, how much they mark everything up. So, whether you call it a markup rate or a percent increase, it really is the same thing. But when we're talking about money in stores, we have discount rates and markup rates. Markup talks about the increase, discount talks about the decrease, percent decrease. All right, so try this problem on your own. See what you get for the percent increase or the markup rate, which is how it's often asked. Okay, so what do we know here? Well, we know the original amount is in the denominator. Be careful here. The original amount was this $16, what they bought it for, what it was before they marked it up. And we don't put how much they're selling it for, right? Or what they sold it for. We want to know how much did it go up or down, so we've got to subtract. 40 minus 16 is 24. So remember, the numerator is the actual increase, right? It increased by $24 total. And now I want to change that to a percent. So I'm going to go times 100%. And then I'm going to reduce. Okay, well, let's see. With 24 and 16, I noticed that 8 goes into both of those numbers. So I'm going to divide both of those by 8. So that's a 3 and that's a 2. Okay. And let's see, 2 goes into 100 50 times. So I'm just showing you the way I do this. Lots of ways to reduce and multiply by 100. So I end up with 150%. So they have 150% markup rate. That's their markup rate. I think actually, usually jewelers have a higher markup rate than that. But notice it more than doubled, right? It was $16. This is more than doubling. So if they doubled it, it would be 100% markup to $32, but it's actually $150. They doubled it and then half more, right? So they added 16 plus 8 more. That's how you get up to that $40. So we have 150%. That is our percent increase. And again, we usually call that the markup rate. Next problem. A prom dress was $178, but is on sale for $103.24. What is the percent decrease? Now, really, that is called the discount rate. All right, you usually, somebody would say, what's the discount rate? In other words, what percent off did they have at the store to only sell it for $103.24? So, why don't you try this on your own first? Okay, again, we're looking for the percent decrease this time. So we have to know how much it decreased. So it was $178, right? And now it's $103.24. So I have to subtract. So let's see. That's 76. That is 4. Looks like it went down $74.76. So $74.76. And in the denominator is the original price. All right, it was originally $178. Now, here's an example where I would use a calculator. So we're going to change this to 100%, multiply it by 100% to change it to a percent. So basically, I'm going to multiply the numerators because multiplying by 100 means you get to move this decimal 2 to the right. So it's 74.76 over 178%. All right, so let's see if that's exact. We're going to use a calculator. Or, of course, you could just start canceling or using long division if you don't have a calculator. But 74.76 divided by 178 is 42. So this is a 42% discount on that dress. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.